agony. Xiu took. Xiu was taken. I sought to tear the empty promise away, to reclaim myself from her shadow. Reclamation, ascension. Onwards, upwards. Find the sun. Look no more over my shadow, into the dark waters, into torment. Even in her madness, she... I felt it too. voice is taunting me. Celine, Celine, Celine. I just want this to end. The servant or the master? I should go there again.
That was so awesome. Holy shit, that was great. Really, really awesome boss fight. And I think that was the last boss fight before the DLC, if I remember right. And I think from this point on, the whole thing just continues to loop. Okay, I can get that. And what's this? Oh, nullifies all malfunctions. Yeah, but probably not permanent malfunctions. I'm just gonna go with damage. I'm probably gonna die soon, because I don't know what this next phase is gonna be about. But I'm assuming it's gonna be me. Oh man, there's a long delay, I forgot about that. Thank you. Oh, there's lots of these guys. That's annoying. Right there. So I have to go back to the hospital after this. So. I knew that was gonna happen. There wasn't much I could do about that. If I hadn't fallen off the edge, I probably would have had at least one more hit in me. Alright, so now final trip to the hospital. And I think that should be kind of it for the main story beats, maybe? Could be wrong, we'll see. There's still scout logs to collect, but I think the bulk of it is just me doing this. Let's find out. These sequences are so creepy and so good. And I read this already. And the document that was there is gone. I'll go in there later. I read this. I actually think this was the document that was over on that, in the morgue area. I read that. This is still the same page that it's been. Let's see. Anything else? Or anything new, I should say. I read that. The elevator's not doing anything. Nothing over here. Okay, I think we can just go to the hospital room and see what happens. She said go back to the hospital. And yeah, all of these have been looked at. And can I go over here? I don't think there's anything over here either. Oh yeah, those I already interacted with earlier. And they moved up. They were there, and then they moved over here. Nothing behind the desk. Okay, back into the creepy hospital room. Oh god, the bed. The bed can be interacted with. That's new. Alright. Nothing else in this room. Just the creepy bed with the indent in the pillow. It's just so disturbing. Alright.
I know you're here. Show me then. What do you want me to see?
Something horrifying, probably.
Is this all I get? Just an empty space where she should be. Moment of respite, at least. A break in the cycle. No pain here. This was earned.
And then I roll credits for a second time. That's funny. This is such a, like, amazing, fascinating game. Like, it evokes in me a lot of the same kind of feelings I got from Silent Hill, the original Silent Hill series, 1 through 3, in particular Silent Hills 1 and 2. I don't know, it's just something about the atmosphere and the nature of the planet that she's on and how it ties into her psyche. You know, like, all of the creatures and enemies you fight in the game are, like, inspired by the trauma that she went through when her car crashed, and she lost her son, because he drowned, like, the car crashed over into the water, and she wasn't able to get him out, but she survived, and she kind of has a lot of, like, trauma and guilt over that, and it manifests on this planet Atropos as all of these horrific things, and she's stuck in this loop. Because she hasn't really been able to find a way, I think, to heal from the loss of her son. And it's kind of like perpetually tormenting her. And it reminds me a lot of Silent Hill, because the town of Silent Hill tends to take on the subconscious attributes of the protagonist. And all the creatures you encounter in Silent Hill are like manifestations of that grief or trauma or whatever it is that the protagonist is wrestling with. And that's exactly what Returnal's like. And so I think that's probably another reason why I love Returnal so much. It's because I love Silent Hill, and Konami doesn't give a fuck about Silent Hill, so I gotta get my fix somehow. And Returnal was an interesting kind of take on that type of story narrative device, like using the character's trauma to kind of create the conflicts that they face in the world, and I think that's really cool. And I love this game. I love this game so much. And this DLC has been fantastic. And it's not over, because, you know, the cycle, of course, never ends. So I'll be able to continue playing this tower mode over and over and over again to see how far I can get. But I think as far as narrative stuff goes, I think this is all the narrative bits besides the extra scout logs I can find and unlock as I play more. But I think that's it. Like, I don't think there's anything further as far as bosses go. I think there's just 3 versions of the boss. I could be wrong. Maybe there's not. Maybe there's, like, another version of the boss if I get past, you know, stage, wherever the heck I left off at, stage 4, phase 4, whatever phase it was. Maybe there's another boss to fight and, you know, more story stuff, but I don't think so. I should look it up. Maybe I will look it up and see. Just a second, while these long-ass credits are going, I'm actually going to look it up and see. Okay, yeah, it looks like that was basically it as far as the true endings go. I think that was it, so I'm gonna skip it. Let's see what. Looks like that was it. And it also looks like when you die, you lose the keys, or when you return back to the area. So I didn't necessarily need to hoard all the keys that I got. I could have just spent them willy-nilly. But yeah, so I guess that's it. Like, I'm basically done for the night. I just wanted to beat the third form of Algos because I had gotten so close. And that third phase is really, really tough. But yeah, this game's frigging amazing. Like, Housemarque absolutely knocked it out of the park with this game. I love it so much. And it's so fun. And this DLC is perfect. Like, I will be playing this DLC regularly from here on out. Because I already beat the main game, got the true ending and the platinum trophy and all that crap. Despite not being a real trophy hunter, I loved this game so much and played it so much, ended up getting the platinum for it. So I think mostly what I'd end up doing is just kind of cleaning up the extra logs and maybe playing enough to unlock traits for all of the shitty weapons that I don't use, unlock the traits for those. But yeah, it's a really amazing game. I'm really happy that I played it and beat it. All that jazz. And I can destroy those, I guess. I was hoping they had obelites in it, but they didn't. But anyway, that's all for tonight. Thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.